In May last year, I started getting really tired. I couldn't get up the stairs in our house. I couldn't work. I kept having panic attacks, just very, very ill.
Cass Beard was 51 at the time, and multiple doctors dismissed her symptoms as menopause.
It didn't sit with me that it was menopause. My gut feeling was like, this is something not right. Like, and I felt like I was going crazy because no one would believe me.
10 weeks later, the mother of one finally had an answer.
It was my fourth or fifth doctor, and she had rung to say that...
You're pregnant.
That I'm pregnant. I've done a first trimester and we really need you to get straight to the hospital tomorrow. Honestly, it was so much shock because there's no way you'd expect to be pregnant.
So to be told you're expecting a baby in your early 50s was...
Yes. Definitely.
Quite
amazing, honey. Yes.
Surprise soon turned to shock at their first ultrasound.
It was just all empty, wasn't it? I mean...
Just a clump.
Just a clump.
There was no baby. Instead, a tumour had formed in Cass's womb in what's known as a molar pregnancy.
There's an abnormal growth of placental tissue. It could be that the egg has no genetic material, or sometimes the egg is just fertilised incorrectly. In most molar pregnancy cases, there isn't a fetus.
Women don't know it's a molar pregnancy until they have a scan.
The symptoms are similar to a normal pregnancy, so bleeding, quite often an increased HCG or pregnancy hormone level, morning sickness.
They said to us I could have a hysterectomy within a few days, or they could do a curette and put me on the emergency operation, you know, this, that day.
You've gone from menopause to... You're having a baby to have a hysterectomy in the space of 24 hours was just kind of like, wow.
A lot.
In rare cases, the abnormal tissue can become cancerous and spread to other parts of the body, which is what happened to Cass.
After the hysterectomy, the results came back and the tissues had spread to my lungs by that stage, which is quite a shock.
Cass suddenly became a patient at the Chris O'Brien Lifehouse Cancer Hospital.
The treatment involved chemotherapy every 2 weeks, intravenously at the Lifehouse. It's daunting when you first get told you're going to be going into chemo. It's very daunting walking into chemotherapy chair.
Molar pregnancies are rare, affecting roughly 1 in 1,200 pregnancies. They are most likely in people younger than 15 or older than 43. Larissa Sebas always wanted to be a mum, but thought she'd left it too late.
I'd turned 40 already. I was with my partner and I'd warned him that I actually didn't think that I was able to be pregnant because of these tests that I'd done in my late 30s, which indicated that I had maybe 1 or 2 years of fertility left.
But at 41, multiple tests revealed she was pregnant.
I was so shocked out of my mind. I couldn't believe it. I just told everybody I've got... news, you know, and I was very, very much looking forward to having this baby.
But at her 8-week scan came the devastating news there was no heartbeat.
And then they told me, we don't know what it is, but it shouldn't be there. And you're going to have surgery. So it all just came crashing down for me then, just like a ton of bricks.
The miracle in her womb was now a ticking time bomb.
I'd come from a position of, I don't think I can have kids, to, wow, I'm pregnant, a miracle has happened, this is amazing, to, we don't know what this is and this might be cancer.
Fortunately, the tumours hadn't spread, and a year later, Larissa found herself pregnant again.
I remember having that ultrasound and they saw the little fetus as it should be there, and then I walked out and my mum and my friend, they're all sitting there and I'm like, yeah, it's a baby. And then all these people are jumping for joy for me. That truly felt like a miracle.
In 2020, Larissa gave birth to a healthy baby boy.
I really thought with my 3-year-old, it would be really nice for him to have a sibling. And so there was always that little part of me that thought, just maybe we might be lucky again.
And she was. In December, Larissa was again expecting. But by January this year, her luck had well and truly run out.
Sure enough, it came back as this inconclusive ultrasound, and it was, again, a complete molar pregnancy.
Only this time, the tumours were spreading through her bloodstream.
The oncologist told me, in no uncertain terms, that I had to have the chemo or this would kill me. But she reassured me that this is the sort of cancer that is 100% curable.
But it needs to be caught early. New South Wales cancer specialists are calling for a register that will help them better track and treat women.
There's a registry in Queensland, Victoria and Western Australia. New South Wales doesn't have a registry. We really need to have a registry to collect the information and provide the specialist services that these patients deserve.
After several months of grueling chemo, Larissa and Cass are both now cancer-free.
I'm really healthy now. I'm happy, energetic, starting work soon.
My beautiful son just turned 4 and I think, you know, as people might understand, life's pretty chaotic with a very energetic boy. I think I just feel so blessed having had a son in the first place that it just helped me move on with being grateful for what I do have.
And with their new lease on life, they have a message for other women.
Listen to your body and keep seeking other doctors. I think that if I had been tested
for pregnancy,
it could have just been sorted out in the beginning. I didn't have to get so sick for so many months.
I just want other women who might be experiencing this to know with the right support, you can get through it and you'll come out the other side.
Oh, yeah, I didn't even know this was a thing.
No.
Can you imagine the roller coaster of emotions, particularly when you sort of, you've got menopause and then you're pregnant and then a hysterectomy or thinking that you're, you know, going to have a sibling for your kid and then you realise it's this thing, like it just... And the words, finding out from someone, we don't know what it is, but it shouldn't be there. Can you imagine hearing that from someone? It would just be terrifying.
Yeah, and devastating.
So scary.
To see them talking about it in the way that they are, with deep reflection, but also wisdom and even a smile, kind of amazingly, but to share their story with other people so that we're all a little more aware is pretty amazing. Right.